great reward for having lived 88 years. Is that for almost a century, I was able to meet and to serve some of the most courageous soldiers and provide the joy of that journey than did my friend Pete Seeger. It was another great figure by the name of Paul Robeson, who said, "Artists are the gatekeepers of truth. They are civilization's radical voice. For many of us, the embodiment of that observation could always be found in the humanity that Pete Seeger displayed in his every deed. His courage was unflinching. His commitment to justice, irreversible. Knowing that there is inevitably a price to pay for speaking truth to power, when facing the House Un-American Activities Committee, Pete made his choice when he said that although the House Un-American Activities Committee had the power to cage the singer, they did not have the power to cage the song." Pete's song was sung for all of us. Through our hymns, he introduced us to ourselves. "Wimoe," the early call out from an anguished black apartheid South Africa to a most indifferent world, was heard by many of us for the first time, and Pete was its courier. When Pete and the Weavers sang it, we danced the horror to Tzena, 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 the joyous song of hope from young Jews in the Negev, only to be led to the tragic melodies of today, sung by Shadi Mansour, and the Palestinian hymns of anguish for innocent children lying lifeless on the beaches of Gaza. When last we spoke, "Where have all the flowers gone?" was on Pete's mind. We chatted about how could so much good that was on our horizon be so swiftly taken from us. But for all the world's turmoil, Pete never blinked on the question as to whether or not our humanity had enough love in its power to triumph over our addiction to our inhumanity. It was at Highland, nestled in the mountains of Tennessee, where first Martin Luther King Jr. heard, "We shall overcome." It was Pete who sang it to him and awakened the world to this slave song that became the anthem sung by a universe hungry for human dignity. Pete made all of this his, made it his mission. But most of all, he made the ending of our pain his common cause. And he was willing to settle for the only reward he would want would be the human triumph over evil. How long will it be before the space he once occupied be filled by another someone the human heart can trust? Pete Seeger left us a legacy. He left it for every Native American languishing on the reservations in America, for every black man, woman, and child in the largest prison population in the world, for everyone hungry, for every refugee in the world. Pete left us all attended to by his art and his incredible humanity. I thank you all for coming to share this festive moment and to permit me to be a part of that celebration.